Do you often receive requests from users to make the table in Data Studio to resemble ones in Google Sheets? Well, this is common because people are more familiar with spreadsheets or Excel format and therefore they want something similar to that. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create the tables that look like this, this, and this in Google Data Studio. First, I'll show you how each table is created in Google Sheets. Then we'll move over to Data Studio to learn how to recreate the same table. In summary, you will find answers to these questions below by watching till the end of this video. This includes how to group rows in table charts, how to create group pivot tables, how to create pivot tables with dimension values, can we wrap pivot table headers and values, how to add or remove subtotal or grand total rows from table. I will also add video chapters so you can jump to the section that you're interested in. So without further ado, let's get started. So now I'm already on my Google Sheets and you can see that we have two types of data here. One is the sales data and another one is the buyer's data. So now I'm going to create the pivot table in Google Sheets first before we move on to Data Studio. So to create a Google Sheet table, just select all the data here and click insert pivot table and you can add that to a new sheet. So now at the right hand side we have a pivot table editor where we can just add field that we need. And if you look back to our example here, we actually wanted a table with delivery country, state and the total sales. So at the rows, we're going to click delivery country and at the second row as delivery states. And for the values, we're going to add price to represent the total sales. So now I'm just resizing the width of the columns. Now you can see that this table has been created easily using the pivot table editors and we can even create some filters to filter the countries that we don't need over here. So for example, I can deselect some of the countries here. And so as you can see in Google Sheets, the first column is automatically grouped together. So we don't have to do additional steps here. But in Data Studio, this is not the case. So let's jump over to our Data Studio and see how this can be done. So first of all, I'm going to create a table chart. Click on Add a Chart and select the simple table here. Click on the canvas to add the chart. I'm going to resize it to make it within this box. And similar to Google Sheets, we are going to select some of the columns that we need in this table. But before we do that, I'm just going to make sure that I'm selecting the right data here. So this is correct. So I'm just going to move on to the next step, which is to select some of the columns that we need, such as delivery country and delivery states. Well, now you will see that instead of grouping the same country together, Data Studio actually shows it repeatedly across the entire table. So now I'm just going to finish off by dragging the price column to the metric field. So how do we make this a group table is that we can change this to a pivot table. So what you would do is you go to this chart, find the drop down and click on this pivot table. And now you are going to move this column dimension field, which is a delivery state, back to the row dimension. And yes, we got this done. You can see that it's exactly the same format that we're getting here, where the delivery country are being grouped together. However, if you can notice, The header is actually get truncated for our delivery country because there's not enough space in this column. So we can just drag this to the right and make sure that we can see every words in this table. So this is how you group rows in Data Studio. But you will notice that this table actually has slight difference as compared to the one at the left-hand side. And if you are paying attention enough, you will notice that in this sample table, we have a subtotal for every country. But in this pivot table that we just created, we don't have that. Similar for the grand total, we have it in the sample, but we don't have it in this Data Studio table. So what I will do now to enable that is to go to your setup and scroll down. You will see this total sections. So for the rows, we are going to add a subtotal and a grand total. By just checking these two checkbox, we get the grand total and subtotal added to this pivot table. Now we are done with the first example. If you have any questions, feel free to just leave it in the comments below. And now I'm going to go back to my Google Sheets and copy the pivot table that we created. So this one, I'm going to create one that's similar to the second one where we have the SKU as our columns. Click on this edit and we are going to add columns for our table here. So select SKU for the columns and you will see this table being generated. So now you know how to create this table in Google Sheets. Next step, we are going to replicate the same thing in Data Studio. So first of all, I'm going to reuse the same chart here from the previous exercise and move it down to this column. And similar to what we just did to our Google Sheets pivot table, add the SKU field to the column dimension and you shall see the same table being generated because we have so many SKUs items. So you can see this width is not enough to show most of the items in one glance. So I'm going to just move things to the left so we can have more items displayed in the first glance. But in order to use this, users have to scroll to the right to see other data. Otherwise, you can also resize your columns to make the view wider. And let's just move this to the left. And you can also choose to rename your field names so you will be able to see the entire column title. Unlike a simple table chart, pivot chart in Data Studio don't have the function that allows us to wrap the text or the title in our tables. So this is one of the shortcomings of using pivot table, but I'm hoping that Data Studio will release an update regarding this soon. So yeah, that's our second example. For our third example today, you can see that in this table, instead of a numeric values like what we used to have in our pivot tables, this pivot table actually has a text for its value. And I actually got inspired by this question over here that I found 2 years ago on Stack Overflow that some has asked about this question, but the response here is that we can't do that. So now I'm going to challenge this and see if I can create the same thing in Data Studio. But first of all, like what we did previously, we're going to just create a pivot table for our data here. So I'm going to just create it at the same place that I have the table. And this is just some mockup data that I just made up for the exercise. So for the rows, I'm going to use buyer ID. And for the columns, we are going to put in, columns. So I'm just going to move it up. And for the values, we're going to create a calculated field, which is the address. And for the summarized by, we're going to select custom. Now this table is created. I can just wrap the table to make sure that it fits inside the box. And you can also see that the grand total being generated along with the column grand total. So now I want to hide them by just ticking on this checkbox over here. So now we have got our pivot table created. So now back to our Data Studio. First, I'm going to just add the chart, which is the pivot table. So now you can see that inside the values is actually the record count. So now instead of record count, we actually wanted the address of each buyer. So now I'm going to just add a field. And here I'm going to just write address for the field name. And for the formula, I'm going to use a formula called max. And inside that, I'm going to just add the field name into it. So now click save and finish. All right, so now I already have the pivot table address added to this data source. And now I'm going to just drag it to our metrics. Now you can see that we have the values here in the format that we wanted, but because of the constraint that we can't wrap the text in a pivot table, you can see that the values are truncated and it's hardly seen by the users. So what I will do instead is to drag the entire width to the fullest and expand the width for the columns. So now you can see that we can actually insert a dimension values in our pivot tables, provided that one buyer can only have one name and one address. So this format might be useful if, let's say, you are running a subscription business, you want to see if the buyer has subscribed to which service and by when. Maybe you can have the values as the date where the buyer subscribed, and the left hand side column you can put the service types, and the columns will be the buyer name, so you can see clearly which buyer has purchased which services. So that's just one of the application, and I hope you find this tutorial useful. If you do, please hit the like button and let me know in the comments below. And I'll see you next time. Bye bye.